Hey everybody, it's me. We're back. We've completed the chapel, which is behind me, so we're going to do a quick walkthrough, and then we're going to get started on our very next project. Are you ready to go? I know I am. So let's get going.
De høyre nykjen på havet skri, for de hev sovet I
So we're back and we're taking a look at our completed chapel or our chapter house. The roof has been reworked. The interiors are pretty much done. We'll just do a quick walk around and show you what I've done. In addition, I've completed the terraforming around this side. So now we have a nice little bridge crossing over from this entryway, and it flows out, which I'll show you, and steps leading up into here, which now that this is an entryway, we'll kind of change this up a little bit, make it look really cool. Steps coming up into the garden, and really, yeah, gives us a nice little look. We've completed the terraforming all the way down. And I'm not completely happy with everything, but it's not too bad. So we've got this kind of cave cavern that leads into where the water river comes out of. And the rest of the rocky face of this is completed. The walls are all finished up. And yeah, pretty happy with the whole thing. Looks pretty decent from a distance, really. So yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. I might do a little bit more. I'm not sure about, I wanted to use the same kind of color palette, but I'm not sure about all this rock. I might change it out to more sandstone. A lot of these are horizontal cut with the exception of the cliff face rocks, which are vertical, which works pretty well on the other side. Doesn't work that much well. Or doesn't work that well over here. So I might do a little bit more terraforming. In addition, there's now a small wall with plants that go all the way around. And there's now a there's now an entryway coming in from here up onto this plateau, so to speak. I really need to do something with this, but I'll work on it. So you can make your choice to go here, still a little bit of work to be done, and then back out to the chapter house. So this makes it a really nice look, and it flows fairly well. It looks good from the outside. And then the interior of the chapter house hasn't changed too much. I haven't really done too much back here at all, other than these two separate rooms. And then we have the balcony all the way around. So pretty happy with this piece anyway. And if you go out onto the balcony, where'd that come from? So you got a really nice look at the Dwarven Kingdom right over here. I'm thinking about putting a big building right about where that cow is, kind of a smelting plant, and then some mines leaning in. But I'm not sure yet. We've still got quite a bit of work to do, not just on the chapel, but the town itself, which we've done quite a bit of work in the last couple of days. But we still have a lot of work to do. So we fly up and get a nice overhead view. I get out of the lag. Oh, the chapel itself. It does look pretty nice. Fortunately, we have some cloud cover, but if we get down low enough that we can see, it does. It has a nice additional shape to it. It ties in nicely with the high seven. Ties in nicely with the basilica, but also with the rest of the buildings for the monastery itself. And this little section of town is pretty much done. There's some minor detail work to do. But I've really focused kind of on this little street right here. And I built this huge tower, which I'm not sure what it is. And this street right here. And if we come up from Burn, you heretic. If we come up from the street level, you can really see it's starting to come together. We've done a lot of additional plant life, built some really nice buildings through here, and sediment, really. Look down the street, it's actually pretty nice. So we've got a relic shop, a couple of houses, which I haven't really figured out yet. And then we have this back alley leading into this courtyard, which we'll do something with. I haven't quite figured out what yet. Which leads us, we'll just go back out onto the main street, or this street. Go down, we have a nice little tavern, a nice little inn. Very shotgun-like. With some kegs and wine bottles here, you can get a good, nice steak drink. You come back here out onto the back deck, back porch, and have a nice drink. And look around. So, and then we've got this huge building right here, which let's go take a look at that. So we've got, we continue down the street, we have this blue building, which I'm not sure what it is yet. And then we have this, which the building overlaps the inn. And I'm thinking this is going to be the house for the innkeeper and his family, with a storage facility here, which is just for deliveries. And then we can go upstairs into the house itself. Nice 2-3 rooms here. And then on the third floor, the nice little rooms up here. And this will be pretty nice once we get it all furnished out. This is a pretty nice little house. So, and we built this building, which is really nothing more than a stairwell. Now there's a back door here, out on this patio, and stairs going down, which there's nothing down there for the moment. And this will lead into this building over here. This is fairly common in some European cities, that a lot of buildings have been slammed together, and you'll have an exterior stairwell going into this building where we haven't built yet. But this guy, I'm not sure what it is yet. It's big. So I'm thinking it has something to do with religion that's got dragon heads on it. But I'm not exactly sure what yet. So really, we've got this little section of town. Oops, too high. This little section of town done, with the exception of these two buildings. We have one building left to build here, or the roof anyway, and floor it out. We cut back around this way. Everything is pretty much done until we get back to here, which we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 and 6 buildings left to do. So I did floor it, or put the foundations in here, and yeah, it's looking pretty cool. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to this. But our next project is going to be right over here, and we're going to build a tower, entryway gate, and a couple buildings right here where these orange squares are. And this road's going to lead off over this way. We'll have some more houses down here, kind of like we did on the other side. It'll lead us up into our main city. So this is kind of going to look like this. And that's what we're going to build tonight. So let's get right into work. Well, it's Union. We're a union company, it's nighttime, the moon's up, so we have to go to bed. So I'll be right. So if you can look from this picture, you can see our palette is going to be mostly sandstone and some brick. I've got my hard copy right here. And I'm thinking this looks about 7 wide, which I think about what I put in here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep, 7 wide. So let's do our sandstone. And we know we're going to need we know we're going to need some sandstone brick. We need some bigger block. Don't need a green window. Let's take a look at what we got here. I might be doing it for the moment. So, I really want to get sandstone, sandstone brick, dirty sandstone. I think that'll do it for the tower. We might do some natural sandstone. So that might work for the tower. So we're just going to start off. This is where the gate's going to go. I don't know about the second natural sandstone. So this is the gate. Well, this is the walkthrough, and I think if you're looking at this picture, I would say it's about 7 high. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 4, 5. Yep. No, we didn't. Why didn't we do that arch? We got a little sandstone arches. Let me, well, yeah, let's think that. Okay. Grabbed a couple extra than I need, but that's fine. So I'm going to put this right here. And then we'll put a line of. So that'll be kind of an arch. It isn't quite the same, but there's some limitations to Minecraft, of course. So, and then that goes up another maybe 4. Yeah, I think maybe 4. And this is just straight. There's no windows or anything on this one. So that's a little too tall. Just eyeballing it. And even that's a little too tall. So we'll take it down right about there. Yeah. And then we'll put battlements up there. Just like that. Yeah, let's take a look at this picture. Yeah. All right, so we're going to put the rest of the sandstone wall in. I'm not going to bore you with the details. We're just going to throw her. Hey, and thanks for coming back. Okay, we got the interior done. I think I'll fill the rest of these walls in. Oops, not like that. That would be kind of cool. Let's take a look and see what that looks like. Not natural. We'll put a couple dirty stones in here. Yeah, that actually looks kind of cool. Then we can put a lantern or something in there. sometimes you just accidentally come across something cool to do. All right. So the sun's setting for the first day. This is looking pretty cool. Now we have some damage rock in our picture right over this side. It looks like we have a little bit of work done there. So yeah, that looks okay, I think. All right. Union. All right. Okay. We're right back where we were. Okay. So, look at the photograph. All right. Yeah. Okay. Yes. So, what we need to do is look at the reference again. About a 2-stone brick wall. And we will use this. Oops, not there. I think that's about high enough. Yeah. Actually a little too high. And then regular sandstone. 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, let's do 2. Then a door. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think 7 would be enough. So, we're going to do this building too deep. For a reason. So, okay. So, by this design, it looks like one more up, there's a window, round window. Now, this is going to be a round window. So, what we have to do is convince our blocks to go round. So, and there's our door with a round window above it. I think if we angle that up, yep. Window. I think it's as tall as we're going to go, because it's actually let's take a look. We might have to raise the tower up. I think it'll look okay. It's kind of angled down. So that'll work. The front's going to be one wide, but we're going to have this one wide in the back. So that's, let's see. Interior is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's a nice 7. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Take this out. So this is going to be our floor. It doesn't show what the shop or house is, but it's just kind of cool by the gate. So we will put in our nice clay or sandstone, natural sandstone floor. Now, if you go back and look at this picture, this window is blocked. So, let's take a nice clear picture and look at it. So it's kind of blocked. All right. So it's kind of concreted in. So let's go get some concrete. I could do clean gray stucco. And it looks like that portion of the window is still open for whatever reason. That really does need to be too high, doesn't it? Yeah. Okay, yeah. Now let's go and find us a nice window. Stone arch window. I wish they had it in sandstone. Let's take a look, see what this looks like. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I kind of like it. Okay. It would work as a one window though, as it gets back to our height that we want. Okay, yeah. All right. So, and this is going to be sidewalk. Cobblestone or something. And we need our doors. Decoration. Nope. Sorry. Let's take a look. Yeah. All right. So we need some of this. Yep. All right. Let's put the sidewalls in, and then we'll get the roof on. Now this is a. Looks like a metal roof, so we can do that. Let's go look at what we got. An iron. Iron block 3, iron block, rusty iron block, just regular iron block. I'll put that there. Iron stairs too. I'm going to grab an iron slab too. I don't know if I'm going to need it. Okay, so make a real simple window. All right, let's see what that looks like. Yeah. It kind of gives you the feeling. I'll put a drain pipe on that one side. I'm going to use a small pillar for this oxidized copper, which makes it look like an old drain pipe. There we go. Take that last bottom off. So that's that building. Next one next to it. Yeah. Now let's take a look at this next one. Just a really kind of a small set of buildings. It's actually set back a little bit from what it looks like. Or it could be anyway. Or actually, it looks like this. This curves out. This curves out a little bit, about there. We're still going to put this building back one, I think. It's about as tall as that lower window. No, I don't like that. Let's go with this carved window again. That might look okay on the inside of these, though. Yeah. Oh, there's a big cross right there. Okay, so we can do that. So we've got four cross and then. All right. A door right there. Window right there. There's like no overhang on that at all. Okay. So, what it looks like. We'll get some. Let's see. About there. I'm going to get some. I like that. Maybe a little bit wider than that. There's going to be a small tree right there. And a bigger, there's a little bit of a wall. A little bit of a sandstone wall, but that tall, just big enough to put a door in, looks like. Okay, well, we're running out of light again today. So we're going to put some more of this dirt down. No. Some more of this dirt down, and then we'll call it a day. And go Minecraft, a beer, and some chips. Okay, I'm okay. Back. Grabbed a birch door. Throw that puppy in right there. And the next one looks like it's not that far away. So there's that. Very interesting, it looks like. It looks like there is a pole right here. That could be a metal pole or something else, but we were going to take this pole and use it to divide these two buildings. So, yeah, and they're like modern electrical poles, so that's fine. But we're going to put a topper on here. Just roll, push this all the way back. Because I'm extrapolating from this photograph that this is actually a garden on this east side of the small building. And that door is just leading into it. At least that's the interpretation I'm going to take, because there's a tree right there. Which we have a tree right here, so that works out pretty well. So what we're going to do is put this wall in. And not pulling out Google Earth, I'm not sure what this building is, but I would assume it's a shop of some kind. It does not look to be a residential house. It's probably a little shop. And yeah, okay. So that, yeah, that looks okay. This does have, oh, you know what that is? That's part of this. Okay, what we're gonna do. We're going to use, it looks like it's kind of a well, it looks like it is a overhang to protect the store. So we will just build one. And this looks really big and clunky, but I think it'll work out all right. Wanted to go two, and now just to go the one. I think just the one would be fine. It's pretty big and clunky. Yeah, I think it looks okay for the moment, anyway. So let's get back over here for a look from the road. Yeah, it looks all right. Just a little tree. So, yeah. Now, this will be another part of the town. I'll have to look at the maps and stuff and see what we want to do for there. But this doesn't look too bad. Like I said, I think it's a little garden because there is a big tree back there. So this wall would actually go back this way. We already have a tree back here, so we won't even mess with it. Other than to even it out. Yeah, nice little courtyard. So we'll finish this wall off. Oops. Put the door right here. I think we're about done. Let's jump back over here and take a look. Yeah, looks pretty good. Now we know on this side, there's kind of a big tree right here. Or not really a big tree. No, actually there's a set of walls back this way. It looks like. Right about here. And then we'll top that with a slab. Yeah. So we're going to cobble this, or put this stone bricket next to something. I'll see stone brick. And I can't remember who I saw this from. It was a really cool trick. Now the Romans, it's getting dark on us. The Romans built roads, as you obviously know. And they built really good roads. And they had a lip on their road. And by doing this, it's like putting a curve on it. Gives you a little bit of architectural detailing. And at the same time, doesn't really mess with the road too much. I started doing this in the upper city. Or actually, I started doing this on the other side. And it turned out really good. I'm going to throw these in here, and then we're going to take a look at it when it gets daylight. And I know my voice is a little froggy today. But I'm feeling fine. I just got a little bit of a froggy throat for whatever reason. Because it's cold and rainy and snowy. I was really torqued off. All right. Let me go to bed. And then
okay, we're back.
Yeah, and like I was saying, I was a little bit of froggy in the throat. Not exactly sure why. I'm feeling fine. No other symptoms. We're still on lockdown or confinement or quarantine or whatever. But I did head out on the motorcycle for about 15 minutes yesterday. Just as I was starting to leave, it got rainy and cold. Just like, bam. So I don't know. So there. But anyway, let's see this. It really makes the road look pretty cool. And we'll do that on this side too. And we'll add some more into this. The city will kind of grow up to the wall. And yeah, we just got to add some lights to this. I think it's looking pretty good. I got to add a few more. Yeah, I do like that. That is so cool. We got to add a few more buildings and stuff over here, but that isn't too bad. That pine needs a couple more deals on it. So we'll flatten this area out, terraform this out a little bit. And yeah. So this is the southern gate into the city. And there'll be some more buildings on both sides. This little area in here will be improved, but not that much. And then the wall itself will kind of kittywampus back around this corner and kind of die out right about here. And just kind of break it down. And then in the lore is over time, they've started using the building blocks to the city to build houses in the city. So you kind of see parts of the wall. And then this road will come or cut around and lead us back into probably right around here. Cut back into this part, and this will be grown up a little bit because trade caravans and what have you are coming in from the south that way, from the east that way, probably even from the west that way. So as they come in, this is what the first thing that they see as they're coming up. So it's kind of an interesting little roadway. We might add a tavern or maybe even an inn back over here, some place where they can stay. And they start coming up into the city for trade. Mostly this is a pilgrim city. So there's like trinkets and what have you everywhere, like our bones and relics. Tavern, of course, you need something to drink. And there's a lot of these places. I'm not sure exactly what it's going to be yet. But I've got to finish that corner. But as the people come in, they'll walk through the city. This is really clean. I have to dirty this up a little bit. And as they walk in, then they get to where they can see the cathedral or the basilica to do the pilgrimage. And, oh, spiders. So we have our well where Saint, whoever his name is, oops, don't want to do that. Saint, whoever it is, heck. Saint whoever, Stephen, what do we name him? I don't remember. Drank the waters and was healed. We've got the, get out of the way, spider. We've got the chapel with a bunch of skeletons in it. Still got some work to do in here. But really happy with the whole layout. And yeah. So, yeah, we've come to the end of another one. It's kind of gone on for a while, I know. But we built up those three buildings. Well, two buildings and a garden. Wasn't a whole lot of build, but it did do some more to the city. Got to look at the cathedral and the chapel and the chapter house. So I'm pretty happy with the whole thing so far. And, yeah, if you kind of look around, look at me. Or look around me, I mean, yeah, this is really nice. I like it. So, that's it for today. I'm going to go do some more work. I hope you have a good day. All right. I'll catch you later.